Blessed are those who mourn in Zion. Isaiah 61, verse 3. In 589 BC, Babylon laid siege on Jerusalem for 3 years. Jerusalem lay destroyed and desolate for 70 years. His own departed with hearts taken captive by other loves.
My heart is that you would come together, embrace my body, embrace me. You break my heart with your cold resistance. Behold my face,
the demolished,
the tears you'll see.
And desolate Jerusalem is a picture of Christ crucified. Slaughtered as he bore us in our rebellion, forgetfulness, and rejection of him. He lays fallow. Forgotten. He is hidden in rubble and diminished to ashes. His land is overgrown and forgotten. His stones are fallen, burnt, and crushed. His people dwell far from him. The people of God dwell at ease in Babylon. They dwell at ease in Babylon, they prosper there. They live a comfortable life there. They are part of the government and thrive in the business. Their children have been raised there. Why should they remember Jerusalem, especially when it is a rubble heap surrounded by enemies? How could they even consider putting their families, finances, and comfort in jeopardy for a ruined city that has fallen? Yet within the people of God who dwell in Babylon, there is a remnant, a heart that is rising in the midst of ease. A heart that cannot give itself rest until the Lord has His rest. Those who cannot build their own house while the Lord's house lies in ruin. Those who cannot tend to their own fields while the Lord's field lays overgrown. This heart rises and rises, revealing itself in those who love Him above all. Let us look at this bride heart in people whom the Bible has spotlighted during this time period. People with one heart for the Lamb to have a wife. We will view them in the order that they appeared on the timeline.